Shabbat Shalom, men. If everyone would please stand, we'll go ahead and open with prayer. Heavenly Father Yahweh, this is Khan Kenneth Hawkins, a CD anointed servant, Yisrael, and by and through the authority of Yahshua Messiah, our great and honorable high priest and judge and soon coming king, asking and praying, Father Yahweh, together with your men as we gather before you, Father Yahweh, again on this the Sabbath day, the 29th day of the fourth moon of Melchizedek, and looking forward to the new moon gathering later, and citing this great moon of Abraham. We call upon your great name, Father Yahweh, as we open up this Sabbath afternoon workshop class, praying, Father Yahweh, for your continued inspiration, your strength and guidance physically and spiritually, as we continually keep this Sabbath sacred and set apart from the world, Father Yahweh, for your glory. And it's all by and through the authority of Yahshua Messiah we pray, as a seed of Yeshua, your servant, being guided by Spirit Holy. Hallelujah, Yahweh. Praise Yahweh. Please be seated, men. We're going to go ahead and continue here in the 20th book of Yeshua, subtitled, It Is Written. Now we're in chapter 5. Okay, chapter 5, it's entitled, We Are in the Last 3.5 Years of End Time Prophecy, and the subtitle is, He Who Is For Sin Must Die by Sin, and that should readily bring to your mind Revelation 13:10, you know, where it's written as a prophecy for this end time here, that he who lives by the sword or war must die by the sword. And of course, it's all referring to sin. This sermon was given on the 20th day of Yeshua, and the worldly date was 02-22-20. And as always, Pastor comes out and he says, Shalom, everyone, praise Yahweh. The peace of Yahweh be with each and every one of you. And before we really get into it, I'd like for everybody, because it's not a real long sermon, but it's one that's just loaded with information. And although we may be reading it along, but please, if you don't have your book, go ahead and write notes. Okay, Pastor goes on and says, the news is really looking great. What is great about it? We foretold it before it ever came to pass, you know, because a lot of times we see such horrible things in the news, but it's great in a way that we could see this prophecy that Yahweh has given unto us in the last days come to pass. So Pastor continues on there and says, that's a great thing, and only Yahweh can do it. Foretelling prophecy. Yeshua quoted a lot about this, and what should come to mind is Matthew 24. He said, when you see this, you should believe everything that Yahweh's prophets have spoken. And of course, we know also that the house of Yahweh is being ordained by Yahweh, is the only place on the earth that could actually bring forth his prophecies. Okay, now he talks a little bit here about the 1074 tag. And verse 3 says, Texas passed a law to let me keep my tag forever. That's an eternal tag. Then write for all of you. That's our eternal tag, the 1074. He says, the great Kohan Benjamin Krause Hawkins, he's working on the administration, and he'll be showing you that. He'll be showing you that I actually mentioned that number 1074 9 years before the state of Texas gave me that eternal tag. So you could see these things are, you know, Pastor's still making a point about how important it is to believe in the prophecies and know that all of these signs that Yahweh is bringing forth is for our well-being, our knowledge, our wisdom, our understanding. The pastor says that's pretty great. Now he starts getting into the sermon here. Now, again, he's talking about this last 3.5 year period. And of course, we know that we're in the end of the last 3.5 years. He says in verse 5, Passover. And of course, you know, they were looking forward, everyone was looking forward to Passover at that time. There are a lot of different scriptures, here a little and there a little. And I always remember that because that's the way pastors always taught. That's the way the prophets taught. That's the way that we can actually understand the laws and the prophecies. Okay? Here a little and there a little, as it's written in the book of Isaiah. That indicate we're going to have a great Passover. I don't think it'll be this Passover. Now, of course, he was referring to last year's Passover. But I could get a surprise right there. It could be. You know, we have to always be prepared and be ready. You need to be in the protected place. The book of Colossians says the feast of Yahweh or a shadow, his shadow from things to come. Okay? We're in the last 3.5 years. We know that. We saw it in prophecy and brought it out to all the world. We're in the last 3.5 years. That Passover was experienced. I don't have time to get to all of it today. It would be great if we could, but it's going to take a while to cover it. I want to touch on some of it right now. It's 6 weeks and 3 days until Yahshua's memorial. And of course, it was 6 weeks and 4 days until the Feast of Passover, the first day of the Feast of Passover, 2020. And then he gives the dates. The dates was, the Roman dates were 4-7-20 was Yahshua's memorial. And 4-8-20 was Passover. Okay, and now this is the part that we all need to just kind of make sure we get in our mind, you know, because we have been here a long time, and there's many that's wanting to come here that's wanting to hear this same message. Pastor says, you need to be here, okay? A lot of people are already getting ready. It doesn't hurt to come early, you know, and we know we even read that in the scriptures that they went up to the feast early, you know, and a lot of times, you know, people has looked at that strictly to help cleanse, but it also was to help to prepare the house of Yahweh for the multitudes that were coming. And it's something to think about, especially with the Feast of Tabernacles is coming up early. Why not come up early, especially for Day of Atonement? You know, if you're not able to come up for the Feast of Trumpets, try to come up for Day of Atonement. That way you'll be here, you'll be settled in, you know, for the feast. Okay, and Pastor goes on to say, you can learn a lot at the house of Yahweh in just one day. So by coming up early, it's an opportunity to be educated and to separate from the worries of the world. Okay, now he continues on there in verse 8, and he says, Satan is really crafty. She's very much against mankind. Mankind is about to receive his reward, as is shown in Genesis 1:26. I will make man in my image and after my likeness, and I will give him what? Authority. You know, this is a lot of what this sermon is about. You know, it's about the authority, the reward that we're working for, to learn to be teachers. You know, not to come just because we're scared all of the hell that's breaking out in the world, you know. I mean, we're not coming just for, if you're coming just for salvation, like Pastor has taught, you know, you're coming for the wrong reason. You need to come to attain righteousness, to learn to serve one another, and also, of course, to become a teacher of righteousness. Now, Pastor continues on there, that authority, that administration, it's an administration of actual peoples that will be governing all that Yahweh brings in. Okay? That authority, that administration, it was given to Satan to begin with, and Yahweh's original sons, which left their first estate. I've got sermons on that, and then if you go further down, Pastor says, the great thing about the house of Yahweh, we answer every question. That is, every scriptural question. We answer it with scriptures. There are no interpretations. We don't interpret the scriptures. We let the scriptures interpret the scriptures, here a little and there a little, just again like it's written in the book of Isaiah. Okay? The end of sin is going to be in this generation. Sin is not going to be allowed into the kingdom of Yahweh. And we know this, you know, and therefore we need to get these little frivolous things that we struggle with, you know, day in and day out, you know, out of our lives. Let's see here. Sin and sinners, you know, of course, included in that, will not be allowed into the kingdom of Yahweh. Praise Yahweh. The sinners are going to destroy themselves in this generation. That's a prophecy shown in the scriptures. In this generation, the sinners, those who will not repent and convert to practicing Yahweh's laws, will be destroyed. Read Malachi 4, 1 through 4, and then do what he says in verse 4. Remember Yahweh's laws, statutes, and judgments. Why they ever did away with them, I just can't understand it. And of course, now that we're here in the house of Yahweh, and Yahweh has allowed us to be called out of the sinful world, we have the same mindset as Pastor. You know, it's hard to understand that people would still just waddle in sin, you know, and this life, that's a temporary life in the world of nothing but wealth and riches. Okay? Pastor goes on to say, the world is being punished for the world's sins, their own sins. Yahweh is not punishing them. Right now, they're punishing themselves. Now, drop down. Pastor says, yes, the sinners are going to kill themselves with the nuclear bombs that the sinners invented in this generation. It started in 1934. That's why, as Pastor has always taught, you know, if we try to be a part of the world, we're supporting that agenda. You know, we're supporting that agenda to actually destroy people with nuclear bombs. Knowledge increase started in 1934. The bomb started. I was born in 1934. Yahweh shows the date of my birth, 828, over and over in these prophecies. We tagged with these numbers, my date of birth, my tag number, and a lot more there. And always remember Pastor's lot numbers there, 17, 28, and 74. Now let's go down to this article. Where it's one that I remember the sermon, and Pastor got very emotional. And it, you know, let's look at verse 13. It says, this article was put out by CNN. It's a post from the Girl Scouts. They're telling the parents here, reminder, she doesn't owe anyone a hug. She doesn't owe anyone a hug. Don't tell your daughter to hug another girl. That's what the Girl Scouts were saying, telling the mother, don't take your daughter and start telling her she owes a hug to some other girl. And then Pastor brings out that, you know, in the X-rated sermons, he brought forth a lot of why that situation brings forth sins, unlawful relations, and things of that sort. Let's see here. And well, go down to 14, because he really gets to the point here, and I remember he was banging on the podium. He said, yes, it does. That's the reason we tell you, listen to me, listen to me, listen. Are you listening? Don't touch. Do not touch. That's why we encourage all of the children to respect each other, you know, and this thing with ownership, you know, that it's all trespassing when it takes place outside of that. And he really wraps it up by saying it there. This world is getting in such a crappy shape. There's danger everywhere you look. Don't touch. Okay? And then Well, that entire sermon, this entire sermon is one to read, but you can read that entire situation as it took place. Let's go over to verse 19. Pastor says, the world is suffering, brethren, really bad. You don't know the half of it because you're protected by Yahweh. They're following a priest who eats pork. They're following a priest that eat pork. Okay, and in verse 20, you know, Pastor brings forth that unclean food that Yahweh tells you is unclean, and also these things that bring forth unlawful relations. The end, this is the subject of the end of man's sin. That's what we're going to destroy. Okay, now the Catholic Church, he goes on to give examples of the Catholic Church, of course, being the ones that have brought this forth about the eating of pork, and of course it's there in Isaiah 65. Let's go down to verse 22. Pastor says, mix sodomy and pork together, and you have swarms of these things in your body that search out and find the STDs that were already there. The STDs that could have been planted by your mother or granddaddy four generations back, they stay with you. And of course, these are the things, and of course, he goes to Isaiah 65 there in verse 25. These sins are from the pure priests that eat swine's flesh. Okay? Now go down to verse 26. And pastor's in Isaiah 65, 1, and he says, and I said, here I am to a nation that was not called with my name. That was quoting that 65, 1. And pastor says, no, they refused his name. Yahweh's prophet Jeremiah said they took it out and caused the people to forget his name, to forget the name Yahweh. We're bringing something, brethren, by prophecy, the name Yahweh, which has been hidden from the world, totally hidden from the world. We brought it back and made it popular. Yes, that's our job. And I could tell you right now, I never heard the name Yahweh before I heard of the house of Yahweh. And that's the majority of the people in the world. Okay? Now let's go up to verse 27. And pastor says, in Isaiah 45, says Yahweh called us for this purpose, so they might know from the rising of the sun to the setting thereof that his name is Yahweh. We're doing it. I don't think I brought with me the blessing from this week. Last week we broke all records. There were almost 2 million people who listened to that broadcast last week. Now what you need to do is go on Facebook and you could see how many views we have today, you know, especially if you look back a week or two on pastor's sermons and easily see over 1 million views. Okay, yes, we're writing and wanting to know how and when they can get here, how soon they can. I said, man, get us some tents. Would you live in tents again if you had to? I would. We are getting ready for you. Believe me, we're getting ready. Okay, and continuing on there in verse 28, pastor reads Isaiah 65, 2. I have spread out my hands all the day to a rebellious people. And pastor says, rebellious people, remember he who eats swine's flesh. Yes, he's rebellious. He's a God worshiper. He's not only stupid, he's evil. Do you know any preachers who eat pork? The world is full of them due to the Catholics. Yes, the Catholics started with Cain. Cain, I brought that out and proven it over and over. Even in the Yematria, it's proven. And then he continues on to a rebellious people who follow Satan. They belong to Satan. 1 Yochanan 3, read that chapter, you'll find out they belong to Satan. They don't belong to Yahweh. They have to repent and convert to belong to Yahweh. And in verse 30, and I'll go ahead and wrap it up here. In verse 30, and he's reading Isaiah 65:2, I have spread out my hands all the day to a rebellious people who walk in a way which is not right, after their own thoughts and devices. Their own thoughts. This is what even the Girl Scouts of America is saying. Don't let your daughter be touched. Don't let your daughter, let her be touched. Okay, and if everyone would please stand, I have the great honor and privilege to turn it over to our next teacher, the great Kohan Matithia Hawkins.
Shalom, man. You can be seated. Yahweh's peace be with each and every one of you. We're going to be picking up here in the 20th book of Israel, chapter 5, where the great Kohan Kenath left off. We'll be picking up here in verse 31. And just to quickly rehearse, the title of the sermon that Pastor gave on 2/22/2020 was, "We are in the last 3.5 years of end times prophecy. He who is for sin must die by sin." And Pastor's continuing on here in verse 31. He's continuing to read here in Isaiah chapter 65, verse 3, where it says, "A people who provoke me to anger." He says, well, the great Kohan, I think he covered that. I hope he did. They can't provoke Yahweh. You know, we know all the time and the effort that Pastor and the priest have spent in showing here in the scriptures, you know, how things were changed in these mistranslated renditions of the book of Yahweh, you know, the King James and the Holy Name versions and different versions of the book of Yahweh, these different renditions, where they tried to make Yahweh look like some an individual who gets angry, you know, like he was just some Joe Blow walking down the street and you made him mad and now he's coming after you, right, with them lightning bolts looking to strike you down. Well, Pastor and the priest have done a great job here showing that you can't provoke Yahweh to anger. They might try, but they can't. They provoke themselves to anger is what they're doing, and to war, hatred, sickness, and disease. And this is the results we see in the world today. You know, the anger that you see amongst society, the anger among the states, the nations, the politicians, the things you see in the schools with the children, the anger and the hatred, the sickness and the disease we see spread through the hospitals and the morgues and the communities. You know, this is the people turning from Yahweh, you know, following this mixture, following this other way that Satan, you know, deceived Eve into following. He says, continually to my face. You know, they're continually provoking themselves to this anger. It's not like they've done it once. You know, it's something they continue to do. Who sacrifice in the gardens. He says, remember the gardens. Please remember the gardens. Genesis 2, verse 9. Okay? Genesis 2, verse 9, where Yahweh warned them, you know, not to partake of this other way of life. Remember the garden where it all started, the garden of genes and greens, genes that came down to you and brought all kinds of hatred and harm. You have headaches, you have toe aches, it goes clear through from one end to the other. You know, and as the great priest covered last week about how, you know, in this time period right now, we're seeing a result, the end result of sin. You know, this isn't the day to see the rewards of keeping Yahweh's laws, because mankind has not been keeping Yahweh's laws for 6,000 years. You know, that day is coming here when these kingdoms change hands and we start to be able to clean up the earth, to clean up the animals, the environment, you know, start to breed out this confusion that's been put within mankind's mind for almost 6,000 years here. He says, if you don't have it, and he's talking about the headaches, the toe aches, you know, these different aches and these pains. If you don't have it, you'll soon have it. And if you had it, and if you had the years for it, it would kill you. I praise Yahweh. We're in the last 3.5 years when the house of Yahweh will be changed. You know, and for your reference, you know, 1 Corinthians 15:51 speaks about, you know, we will not all sleep. We're not all going to be put into the grave, but we'll be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye. You know, this is one of the great goals to look forward to be able to, you know, get rid of this defiled blood and to be able to have the Spirit of Yahweh to give us life eternal. You know, this is what we're working for day by day, men, when we're striving to overcome carnality, God worship, and illegal lust and illegal desires. You know, we're proving and qualifying to have that Spirit of Yahweh, this perfect righteous Spirit which will sustain us forever, you know, without getting defiled as blood, you know, becomes defiled. And over the years, blood becomes defiled. That's why when you're young, you know, you trip, you fall, you might bust yourself up pretty bad, man, you healed up in no time, super quick. You know, as you age, you know, sometimes you get bruises and stuff. It could take months or years for those things just to go away. But we do have this promise, you know, we don't have enough years to all experience this sickness and disease, the headaches, the toe aches, all these things brought back, you know, from Cain and his followers all the way down to these last days. You know, our days here are very short, where we're going to see these kingdoms change hands, you know, and that's a great promise that Yahweh gives us. In Isaiah 65, continuing in verse 3, he says, "And burn incense on altars of brick." In verse 4, "Who assemble and spend the nights, keeping memorials to the dead." That is Halloween, to the dead. That's dead rabbis. That's where you get the word Lord. You preachers, wake up there now. This word Lord, it comes from dead rabbis. When you tell the people to use the word Lord, you're having them pray to the dead. Isn't that just a little bit stupid to have them pray to the dead for the living? Okay, so you can see here they're not calling upon Father Yahweh. You know, the world is not calling upon Father Yahweh. You know, they've been taught these lies from their parents and their grandparents and their great-grandparents and, you know, whoever was preaching to them. You know, these things have come down for thousands of years from Cain and his followers all the way down to this last time period. You know, these gods have no power to save. You know, and this is going to be the big awakening, men, you know, for the world, is when they see that their gods are useless, you know, because when people start to experience great distress, you know, when their normal lifestyle is changed, you know, they seek their religions, their churches. You see this time and time again in the news, you know, when there's earthquakes and cyclones and these horrible natural disasters that come through cities and states and such, you know, people usually run to their churches and, you know, there is no saving them there. Now, if you jump over here to verse 40, Pastor says, Leviticus chapter 11, I want you to think on this one. This is one of the grandest things that has been passed over by Christian people who can't think. Their minds are so boggled, they can't think. They've got their minds on the world. I want to go here tonight and see if I can find pleasure. I've got to waste some time. I just can't stand it here. I can't stand it here in this house anymore. Study means nothing to me. I don't want to read. I want to go have fun. You know, this is this worldly thinking, you know, that we have to, as Pastor said many years ago, you know, none of us, you know, instinctively have that desire to study. It's just not something that's within us, you know, but it's something you have to build upon. You have to make studying and learning an enjoyable thing, which means you have to put time forth in doing so. You have to, Pastor talked about preparing your desk and having an area where you can go sit to study, you know, so it's not a huge chore or task for you, but making it enjoyable, you know, because very few of us grew up like Pastor did. You know, we didn't grow up in the 1930s. You know, we didn't have our mother reading the scriptures to us every night as entertainment. You know, we grew up in houses with television and radio and, you know, other forms of entertainment that started coming about very rapidly just a few years after Pastor was born there. You know, started when he was born with the television, you know, and became very widespread within a very short number of years to get rid of this morality, you know. And he always called us out of that. He's called us out of that confusion, but we have to put forth the work, the effort, you know, into building our mind, you know, as if we were, you know, if you've ever built a building or a dwelling, you know, or you know, put something together, you know, you have to put forth effort. You know, you can't buy something in a box, you know, open the box, dump everything out on the floor, and it just puts itself together. You know, you have to follow the instruction manual. You got to read it. You got to follow it and put this piece there and that piece over here to make everything come together perfectly. And it's the same thing with our minds. You know, in order to get our minds thinking on Yahweh, we have to put forth the effort and study and seeking Yahweh through the books of Yahweh and the books of Yisrael to get this righteousness into our mind where we actually start to crave these teachings. When Pastor's talking here about the world here and the Christian people whose minds are so boggled, where they drag back the night and a half drunk, they get back, some of them killed on the way back. I'm telling you, that's the world. It's going on constantly. And if they don't get shot or knifed, killed in road rage, wake up. Yahweh is talking to you. You know, he's speaking to the world here about trying to bring out, you know, from this confusion. Leviticus chapter 11. This chapter was written in 1490 BY. If you don't have that in your Bible, write it down. 1490 BY. Today is 2020 when he gave this sermon. Now we're in 2021. But that was 3,510 years before 2020 AY. They can see microorganisms now, but you can't see microorganisms with the naked eye. Think for a minute. How did Yahweh know there were unclean microorganisms in swine's flesh? How? Come on, hit yourself on the head or something and get your brain to going. Yahweh told you this. Yahweh knows and told you. Don't eat pork. Yahweh can foretell the future. Only Yahweh can do this, so why are you rejecting Yahweh? You know, and this is what we have to do when we have tests and trials and struggles, is see why it is that, you know, our mind is trying to get us to reject Yahweh, reject Yahweh's wisdom. You know, because before mankind had microscopes and laboratories, you know, and had any inkling of figuring out anything, you know, if you just look back like 100 years ago, you know, mankind's theories and the things that they would do for health, for nutrition, you know, you can see how even today, you know, science, they're changing year by year in what they say you can do and you can't do. You know, years ago they say, oh, the sun's bad for you. Now they say, oh, you need the sun. You know, years ago they'd say, oh, salt is bad for you. Oh, you need the salt. You know, all these different things that mankind's just now realizing. Yahweh wrote these things thousands of years ago. You know, so you can see the wisdom that Yahweh has, how he can actually foretell the future. He can see these things thousands of years before they ever come to pass. Verse 43 says, you preachers out there, I'm talking to about a billion of you right now, preachers who are leading your people to eat pork, to poison their bodies, and telling them the Ten Commandments are done away with. Yeah, you're the ones that did it. You did away with them to the people, not to us. You didn't, and you never will. You know, the house of Yahweh has been pulled out of that deception. We're learning the way of life from the tree of life, from the great house of Yahweh, from the one Yahweh has sent to teach us life. Now, this word preacher here, because Pastor says, I'm talking to you preachers. This word preacher in the Oxford Language Dictionary, it says, a person who preaches, especially a minister of a religion. You know, a lot of times you hear preacher, you think of, you know, someone who runs a church. And yeah, preachers do run churches, you know, but any person who promotes or teaches ministers of a religion, you know, can be a preacher. And I always look at that when Pastor says, you preachers out there, you know, any one of us could become a preacher of Baal if we turn away from Yahweh's instruction. We turn away from the guidance and the wisdom that comes from Yahweh. You know, if we start teaching another way, you know, and this is the warning that pastors are given about, don't reject Yahweh's wisdom. You know, we don't want to be one of these prophets of Baal by teaching our own ideas and our own ways. This is why it's important. In this sermon, pastor was making certain references to certain things, like, you know, children not touching, how it's inappropriate and improper, and it leads to problems later in life, you know, and he's going to get in here about keeping the Sabbath day, you know, how you can't break the Sabbath, not even one. You know, these things are very important for life, you know, and if we go and, you know, say, oh, you have a headache today, you know, you should probably just stay home, or, you know, if we start offering up another form of religion, you know, we start offering another way, you know, other than this way of life that has come from the house of Yahweh, then we become these preachers who are leading the people to eat pork, poison their bodies, and telling them the Ten Commandments are done away with. You know, we have to be on guard against these things, men, because, you know, Satan, she's a worker. You know, she's not sitting around on the recliner watching the television or playing on her smartphone. You know, no, she's diligently working to try and to mentally attack the saints of Yahweh to cause them to fall away. You know, to turn us from this perfect way of life. Now, pastor says here in verse 46, no man could have told you, or no man could have told them that pork was unclean. How could they know it? If you eat a big batch of it, you don't even know it. You don't even know that you've poisoned yourself. And then years later, your body starts breaking down. Add sexual sins to it, and it starts breaking down sooner. And you just can't stand it. Your children are born deformed. What difference does that make? I just want to live my own life. I didn't want that child when I had that child. I should have aborted it. That is the world's attitude, brethren. You know, pastor's showing here with the thinking of the world. You know, this confused mentality that's shown in the world, where there's the love has grown cold, as was prophesied. You know, as Matithiah showed, in, or as Yeshua showed in the book of Matithiah. You know, and even how in Romans it talks about the natural affection would be lost. You know, Romans chapter 1. You know, this is what comes down, you know, from years of eating pork. Sure, you know, our granddaddy might have ate pork and he might have lived to, you know, 60, 70, 80 years old. You know, yeah, many did. Many did. But look what's come down to now. You know, look at what we see in society today, the senseless lack of thinking. You know, there's a lack of thinking in society today where some of the speakers spoke today, you know, that, you know, there's just a confusion. Like, you can have a family without having a family the way Yahweh directed and having a family. And they start, you know, just thinking that, you know, because you thought it, you can say you are it, and that just changes everything. You know, instead of, you know, seeing the importance of how Yahweh put everything in its place. You know, everything set in a certain motion to do a certain job. You know, and how, you know, mankind, you know, how we have to have things set into motion. We have to, you know, eat clean foods to have clean bodies, to have clean minds, you know, to live without, you know, the feeling of pain and hurt and suffering, you know, and how they have to do that continually to the third and fourth generations, continually, so they can experience the great rewards that we read in Deuteronomy chapter 28, you know, the great rewards that come from keeping Yahweh's laws, you know. And this is exciting to look forward to, man, that in 3-4 generations, we're going to start to see, you know, little Yeshuas that are, you know, just young and healthy and vibrant, you know, at way old ages, you know, 90, 100 years old, you know, how things are going to start cleaning up very rapidly. You know, it took 6,000 years for Satan to destroy the earth, and Yahweh's sons and daughters are going to clean it up in 1,000 short years, get it back to its true beauty. The pastor says, you know how many million babies you've murdered out there because of eating pork? Yeah, your mind is poison. You know, it takes confusion of the mind to kill a baby. You know, it takes confusion of the mind. It's not just something someone wakes up and says, I'm going to kill a baby today. You know, it's something that's been bred into them. 3 and 4 generations going way on back to this garden of jeans and greens where Cain chose this other way. Yeah, your mind is poisoned. You're confused. That's what Yahweh tells you. And that you will do when you do these things. That is when you commit sexual sins, when you eat pork or anything that is unclean. Yahweh shows you the clean and the unclean, even fish. How did he know that? A man couldn't know it. No man could know that until 1,000 years later when we invented the microscopes that show all the life forms that are in these unclean animals that we have stuck into our bodies. You know, so you can see without Yahweh's wisdom, all right, without Yahweh's wisdom, and this, as pastors spoke of, you know, that the Ten Commandments, you know, were the Ten Commandments when he was a child, they were taught. You know, it was something that was taught in their family. It was something that the community lived by, you know, where they kept those Ten Commandments. You know, and that's actually what allowed, pastor said, that's actually, you know, you see in the Ten Commandments that mankind was actually able to come down, you know, almost 1,500 years, you know, 1,600 years, no house of Yahweh, no teacher of righteousness, and they were able to come down to these last days because of those 10 laws. You know, it shows you the power in Yahweh's laws, you know, and, you know, Yahweh could, he can show these things in the scripture, you know, the fish, for example. Like, if you went out there and you went fishing and you caught something, I mean, how would you know if it's, you know, healthy for you or not healthy for you? You know, Yahweh wrote it. He showed us, you know, but without Yahweh's wisdom, we'd just be like the rest of mankind, you know. It looks fat. It looks yummy. Let's cook it, you know, try it out, you know. And you can see, you know, there's even certain societies today where their main diet is a lot of unclean foods, you know, and you can see the lack of education, the lack of the scriptures, the lack of a righteous teacher, you know, and people just go in their confused way, and then they're wondering why they're having, you know, babies that have all these extra arms and legs and, you know, heads and different things, and they can't figure out why these things are so. You know, they might check their diet a little bit. And praise Yahweh, man, it's a great blessing. You know, I think of that often. It's a great blessing to have Yahweh's wisdom, you know, in our lives, that we can have the direction. Even the wisdom the pastor showed us in these last days, you know, where certain food supplies that would normally be a clean animal, you know, but because of the way men feed them and you know, put things into their bodies and put things into their diet, you know, becomes not acceptable for a saint of Yahweh. You know, as we've been covering in the first book of Israel about, you know, with the cows and the beef industry. You know, they actually feed things to the cow, you know, that a cow wouldn't normally eat. Now, in verse 51 here, he says, notice, he's speaking to you, and he's reading here in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 24, which says, let us consider one another, how we might urge one another on toward ahab and righteous works. You find that in Yahweh's righteousness. Yeshua said in Matthew 6:33, seek first the kingdom of Yahweh and his righteousness. You know, our number one goal in these last days, seek first the kingdom of Yahweh and his righteousness. You know, as Pastor's been showing us here lately, not just salvation, not just saving ourselves, you know, getting eternal life. No, seeking Yahweh's kingdom and his righteousness first and foremost in our lives. Then why did you want to do away with Yahweh's righteousness? He's speaking to the unbelievers, you know, speaking to those who turn from this righteous way, you know, and giving us a warning, man. When Pastor speaks to the world, he speaks to these preachers of these false religions, you know, whether they're your neighbor or, you know, whether they're, you know, those that are doing things they're not supposed to be doing, that pretend to be doing what is right. You know, he's encouraging us and exhorting us to pay attention here, to make sure we're not doing away with Yahweh's righteousness. Why did you do away with the seventh-day Sabbath, the fourth commandment? If you break one, you're guilty of breaking them all. Why are you going to church on Sunday to learn the way of the sun god Baal, who tells you stories of Santa? You want to believe Santa Claus? Why can't you believe Yahweh, who can tell you something in advance, thousands of years, and it comes to pass? The prophet Isaiah also told you that in the last days, I will establish my house. In the last days, not earlier, it won't be there. The Catholic Church was there, but not the house of Yahweh. In Elijah's day, there were 450 of you guys. Those were the men. Jezebel had more than that. She had a lot more than 450. Elijah was Yahweh's only prophet. You know, and if you remember here in verse 43, Pastor says, I'm talking to about a billion of you now. You know, so you have Pastor who stands as Yahweh's lone messenger, you know, preacher of salvation, you know, preacher of Yahweh's righteousness, the one sent, and you have a billion preachers of Satan, you know, at every turn. You know, whether you turn on the news or you pick up the newspaper, you know, always promoting these ways to have a healthier life, you know, and enjoy life without following Yahweh's righteousness. It's impossible. You know, mankind's been trying it for 6,000 years, and they've brought themselves down to where now they're just itching to kill each other. I mean, that's what you see when you turn on the world news. You just see this nation and that nation just itching to kill each other, you know, given like real strong verbal threats. You know, like, I can't remember. I think there was one leader of a country. We played on the news here lately. He said something about, you know, you knock out a bully's teeth and he won't ever mess with you again or something, you know, basically implying if you mess with us, we're going to knock out your teeth and you're never going to mess with us again. You know, and others have said, you know, if you mess with us, you know, we'll burn all your cities. You know, this is the intense amount of confusion that you see in mankind. You know, these things are not natural. They're not Yahweh's way. I mean, this is why you have all these problems in psychology and all these mental health problems, because, you know, they're forcing and teaching people to do things that is against the way Yahweh created man. You know, he created man to care for each other, you know, to be a blessing and a servant to each other, not to go out killing each other. Hebrews 10:26, for if we sin willfully, this is in verse 55 here on page 37, he says, notice, don't forsake this assembling of yourselves together because it's sin. Breaking this day is sin. Not keeping the Sabbath is sin. Okay? We have to realize that, the importance of the Sabbath day. How important it is in keeping Yahweh's Sabbath as Yahweh kept the Sabbath. For if we sin willfully, read the rest of this. Yeshua said it. I'm not telling you this, Pastor said. Yeshua said it. He's the high priest over the house of Yahweh. He's trying to put these laws in your heart. The most wonderful thing that anyone can do is make you ahab Yahweh. Brethren, in these last days, it's hard. It's hard to pull anyone out of this sin-sick world. As sick as it is, it's hard to get anyone to see because their minds are so confused now. They're blobs. They've got these abominable things in their vessels. And yes, they slow down and confuse the brain. It's hard to get in there with truth. Yahweh said we're going to find about 2 billion, and they're going to be coming here to his house. That's what he said, coming to the land of Israel, praise Yahweh. You know, so there will be a remnant of people that will be saved from this destruction, you know, and they are going to assist us in cleaning up the earth, you know, and getting it back to its original glory. And we men, we have this opportunity to be standing right there with Yahweh's servant Israel, you know, pushing this work forward. You know, we just have to, diligently adhere to these teachings and recognize, you know, when we disagree or we don't understand something, you know, it's probably some of that confusion we've inherited. You know, beg Yahweh to help us to be in 100% agreement with His house, with His servant Israel, and all the teachings that's being brought forth from the great house of Yahweh, so that we'd be able to have this eternal position in Yahweh's great kingdom as being, you know, sons of Yahweh, the great peacemakers of the universe. And that's all the time we have for, men. If you all stand, we'll go ahead and close in prayer. Yahweh, bless the rest of your Sabbath. And just a reminder, we have the new moon this evening. Great Father Yahweh in heaven, this is your servant, Kalmatithi Hawkins. I come before you in unity, body of priests, and being seated of the witness, Israel Hawkins, the third great honorable high priest, Yeshua Messiah. I come before you, Father Yahweh, the great priests, the great deacons, and the great men, and the young sons, your joy, born in your great house. We thank you, Father Yahweh, for the great blessing of being called out of this evil world and being able to have the only true light, the only true teacher, Father Yahweh, in this entire earth, Father Yahweh. And we thank you for your servant Israel. We thank you for these books of Israel, these great words of life, this golden oil that we can, you know, take home with us and open up any time, day or night, Father Yahweh, that we're seeking you and struggling through trials or tests or difficulties. We pray, Father Yahweh, that we would be free of the confusion of our minds, to be able to be humble enough to seek you and seek your guidance daily, the wisdom that comes forth from your house, and that we would apply these teachings in our every interaction, that we'd be able to be righteous examples and be able to qualify for the great positions that you have set for us. And we do ahab you and praise you, Father Yahweh. We pray for all our brothers and sisters who are held in prisons or foreign countries, for their zeal and strength to endure the time of your great deliverance. We do pray, Father Yahweh, for safety and protection for them. We also pray for those who are sick and suffering, for their health, their healing, and their strengthening. Continue to comfort and be with them so they'll be able to continue in this work as they desire to do. We pray and ask all these things in complete unity, the body of priests, being seated with Israel and through a great honorable high priest, Yeshua Messiah, we do pray. Hallelujah, and praise Yahweh. Yahweh bless you, men.